Hello. Welcome to this show. This show is called Johnny Sizzle's Entertainment Watch, and I'm the host that has such a big ego that he has to call a show after him, his own name. I'm Johnny Sizzle. Okay. Thanks for tuning in. Usually we have bands on, and why? Because we promote young performers that are coming out and everything like that, just coming out. Give them a little extra advantage as far as, you know, recognition is concerned or something like that. But it's all types of performers, all types of music, all types of acting, poetry, art, skateboarding, like anything. Also, I'd like to say hello to Johnny Skater and the Elf Posse. Hello to Heather. A hi to Tracy. A hi to Shane. And Shane would like to say hello to Menudo. Also, I'd like to say a special hello to the guy who broke my glasses while slam dancing at a certain Winnipeg Punk Fest. And today we have a real special show because we have a special phone-in poll on whether I should shave my head. Now, here's what I look like with a shaved head. All right. Now, if the yes vote to yes, shave my head, outnumbers the no vote to not shave my head, if it outnumbers it, yes, then on an upcoming show, my head will be shaved by whoever I have on in the show. Now, if the non-shaved head vote is the winner, then I will keep growing my hair, and this is what I look like with lots of hair. All right, okay. It's your choice. You can phone in. I'll give you a number throughout the show. Also, if you're interested in being on my show, I'll give you a number around the end of the show, too. And we'll have an update throughout the show, what's going down. Now, why don't we just get this started? We have the group Tasty Fish with us today. They're going to show a fabulous video. And they might not play, but I don't know. They might play. So they'll have a video, and they're called Tasty Fish. We'll do this right after a PSA. Hey, welcome back. Welcome to the show. We have Tasty Fish with us. Hey, we're trying out much music kind of thing, you know. All right, here's Tasty Fish over here. Let's get the names of the members of the bands. This is
Pat, Dale, James.
Oh,
and Jed.
Now, why the name Tasty Fish? How'd that come all about?
What was that?
The name Tasty Fish.
I don't know. We just thought of it.
Just thought of it?
Like, it's in the dictionary.
No, it's from The Simpsons.
No.
It's from The Simpsons. Yes. It's on an episode where Homer goes to, deja vu, he goes to, a Japanese restaurant, and he's gonna die, and it's a long story, but it's in.
But
he was gonna eat the poison
fish.
Blowfish.
Yes. Not like the poison blowfish.
All right.
And he's gonna cut it up, like the chef's gonna cut it up, and he goes, he's watching a map, and he goes, poison, tasty fish, and he cuts it.
He's reading it off the manual.
Oh, okay. Well, that's interesting, you know.
Really?
Wow.
Okay. Now, what has the reaction been from playing around town for you guys so far?
I think him. Who's
James?
James. I think James should answer
that. Go ahead.
Well.
Anyways, I think.
Thank you.
Go ahead, James.
Go ahead, James.
I think I'd rather give that to Jed.
Phew. That's a pretty tough question.
Put Jed on the spot.
I'd actually have a really hard time answering that. I think we should get Dale to do that, because he wasn't there, so he's the best to know.
Well, what I heard was that stage was rushed, girls everywhere, and Pat will finish the story.
And actually, the reaction was pretty good so far.
All right. That's
yeah.
Good.
They, they didn't kill us or anything, so.
Oh, that's good, huh? Yeah. Now, would you guys, I hate saying this question, but what would you guys think you sound like? What do you guys think you sound like? So people have an idea.
Well, it's kind of like, I don't know, Nirvana meets Blue Rodeo.
Oh!
Whoa, what a
deja vu.
I think you said that to me before.
I think I may have 10 minutes ago.
Oh, yeah. Okay. What type of audience are you looking for? Is it a mixture or stuff like that?
Cats. dogs?
No, I...
ducks.
I think that...
Seriously, though.
Well, basically, anyone that'll listen. But, you know, we'd hopefully would be a little more than just an entertainment band, so to speak.
All right, okay.
A serious musical group.
Okay, I'm going to ask you guys questions out of a university newspaper. They're called the Syllogist. Sometimes they're a pretty informative piece of toilet paper, but other times they're good paper. It's an all right paper, you know.
All right.
Okay, we're gonna.
There wouldn't be anything in there by Hildebrand, would there?
No.
What's that guy's name?
Oh, no, we're not gonna use that guy. Okay, we're gonna use someone called Ethan Lincoln.
Mr. Lincoln.
So, and he wrote an article. He or she wrote an article. I'm not sure.
You're never sure.
Yeah. Guy name.
Ooh. But if he or she is watching, you might be mad.
You might be angry.
All right, now Ethan wrote an article called "Are You Neurotic?" and we're gonna ask Tasty Fish if they are neurotic. Okay, guys. Judd, do you constantly think about shaving your head?
What do you mean?
Well, do you?
What are you talking about?
Okay, all right.
I think what he's saying.
No, I've actually never thought of it.
You never thought about it?
No, right. I don't really see the point in it.
All right, James, weekends, are they usually filled with frequent visits from your relatives trying to sell their children for food?
In between sex?
Male or female?
Well, James?
No.
No, okay, all right.
A man of few words.
All right, I don't know. Okay, here's one about The Simpsons. I'm going to ask the Pat, because he's the Simpsons kind of guy.
Right. I am the anthology of Simpsons.
All right. Do you believe that our present government is overrun by aliens who are sub... Can you read this word for me? Sub...
Weekends are usually... No. Which number, man?
That's number 4.
I believe that our present... Do you believe that our present government is being overrun by aliens who are subliminally... controlling us through television shows like The Simpsons, well, T or F?
Well, what do you think? What do you think?
F.
You mean it's false?
Yeah, it's false. It's Married with Children, actually.
Okay, all right. I'll just ask a really quick one. I don't know. Should your dog have a mohawk? I don't know.
His dog does have a mohawk.
It does?
Or an Iroquois, for that matter. Yeah.
Really? Does your dog really have a mohawk?
Does that mean Dale?
Yeah, I'm afraid so.
Are you neurotic?
Oh.
I hope not.
I guess that would be, wouldn't it? Or?
But I guess Judd and Dale are neurotic people.
What do you mean?
Oh.
Another great mystery cleared up.
Wow.
It's right up there with the caramel secret.
Why don't we throw this out and talk about the video right now?
All right.
Thoughts on the video? Okay, guys, what are the thoughts on the video?
James.
Haven't seen it yet.
A qualified answer.
How about Judd? I think you've seen it, right?
Yeah, I saw it quite a few times, actually. What do you want to know about it?
Well, what are your thoughts so far?
It's basically about 8 minutes long. It's kind of our attempt at a documentary, making fun of ourselves, making fun of a documentary, a video, kind of funny stuff.
All right, you guys are all in it.
Yeah, except for
James isn't. He's there in spirit, I think.
That's why I didn't know what was going on, because I was the newest member to join.
Yeah, All
right, and you made the video. You shot the thing.
Yeah, it was a ceramics class I took. No, it was, we got a friend of ours, Darren Oler King, a very good friend of ours with very, very light blonde hair, and he used Pat's camera, and followed us around for a few hours, a couple days, and took pictures of us. I took it back and affected it and edited it together. And
you got it out.
And I think there's a shot in there of me in a t-shirt standing by the Red River in, like, October. And
it was a little cold.
You can see my nipples are hard. It's like, I'm just, hurry up.
Wow.
And I have hair.
You have hair up for the video. Yeah. Okay, well, why don't we watch the video right now? It's a video from Tasty Fish.
Ladies and gentlemen, the story you're about to see is true. The names have been changed to protect the innocent.
You'll never know how much you mean to me. You'll never know how much I care. V Because whenever we're apart, I get a pain in my heart that tells me there's something out there. My forefathers were brought over on a boat from Botswana with a load of rotting bananas. and a bunch of smelly fish. So that's why the band came about. This is tasty fish because on the time when they were on the boat, they were thinking about tasty fish. So that's how it happened.
I'd say it's a release for the members as far as day-to-day drudgery goes. For myself, I find playing really just, you let loose a bit more. Your inhibitions are, it's like getting drunk. You can let go a bit, you know, have a good laugh. You can hit something, you know, drums, keys, strings, whatever it is.
Have you ever been a member of any subversive organization?
Question, please.
Have you now or have you ever been a member of any subversive organization?
Can you read the question again, please?
Are you now or have you ever been a member of any subversive organization?
No comment.
Did your parents ever dress you in those little stupid sailor outfits when you were like 4?
Aha!
This version of a documentary called Whatever. Tomorrow creeps its petty pace from day to day. Aye, there's the rub. For in this sleep, what dreams will come? Yes. Once more onto the breach, my dear friends, once more. Away, away to Camelot. Thank you very much. Master Thespian, thank you. Sponges, me, you. Okay, that's enough. That's enough.
Before I start talking to you guys again, I'd just like to see the poll on my shaved head. How's it going? Okay. All right.
Looks like you're going to be soon.
I noticed there was a new face there. His name was...
Dwayne Newman.
Where is he?
Pat?
Well, I'm Pat.
Where's Dwayne?
Where's Dwayne?
Okay.
Dwayne's in Victoria. He's playing hockey for the Victoria Cougars.
He's their captain.
Did I mention that? He's their captain. And he, little known fact, he currently owns the record for the Ironman thing in the WHL.
Oh, he's played the most games.
In a row. Yeah. 190 consecutive games. Sorry, Dwayne. 190 consecutive games or something. Probably more by now.
Yeah. An amazing record.
And he even played with broken ribs one time. He told me that. Wow.
He's quite an amazing guy.
He is.
The downfall
and he's
is
bigger than
he's
us,
missed
so we have
about 2,000 rehearsals.
Yeah.
We have
a little chat with him.
Did he try out for the Jets? As a matter of fact, he did.
He was asked to come and try out. He was at the Jets training camp and he did pretty well. He got some interest from other teams around the league. Uh-huh. That kind of thing, and they had a big article on him on the last page of the Sun.
Oh, that's interesting. Well, how about this? by the way, what's Small Fry Productions? I was wondering what that was.
That's a kind of a pun. Not that pun. Small Fry is just a personal joke. Personal inside story.
Okay.
Not that inside.
Okay. We'll take a PSA. We'll come back and you guys will do some jamming or playing for us.
All right. Yeah, all right.
Okay.
Ooh, groovy.
We'll do that.
Funky.
Down.
One, two, three, four.
Cocoa day in the spring to wash away my fear, my behind, to understand why I must stand alone. as you fade away. I can't believe my eyes and know that it's all real. And still I can't believe that you're gone. Now it seems that I'm the one who has to lead a life worth living, even though I don't know what I'm doing here. And I guess I'll be alright, but I really need your help right now. If you were here, I'd ask you what to do now. Yeah, if you were here. Days of anger and confusion, I could almost hear your voice. I know it's true that sometimes things don't work out quite that way. And I know you'd want me to be strong inside, but you know sometimes it gets a little hard. Well, I don't have much more than time anyway. Now it seems that I'm the one who has to lead a life worth living, even through all the anger and the fear. And I guess I'll be alright, but I really need your help right now. Here I'd ask you what to do now. Yeah, if you were here, you were here. Ask yourself, what does it mean? You were here. Who had the right to take you from me? You were here. You never had the chance to say you were here. The kind of man that I might be. Now it seems that I'm the one who has to lead a life of living, even though I don't know what I'm doing here. And I guess I'll be alright, but I really need your help right now. I'd ask you what to do now. Yeah, yeah, if you were here.
Woo, that was good. All right, this is Tasty Fish here. Is there a number to call for if people want Tasty Fish's service?
In fact, yes, there is.
The number to call is 256-8340. That's my number.
Oh, this is scaled down version.
All right, we're going to end the show right now. Let's check out my poll right now, whether I keep my hair or not. And hey, I keep it. Right on. All right.
Oh.
Next week. Should Martin grow sideburns?
Right on. Oh yeah. Okay. I'll be next show.
We'll do that next week.
Yeah. Okay. All right. And remember, if you want to get on the show, the number to call is 338-6929. And remember, be nice to yourself and be good to your mother.
I don't know what it means.